Hello. Gonna make a 1 gallon size crock now. I always throw out a bottom just because I've had a problem with S cracks, and this way you can really get that bottom compressed. Well, I'm gonna throw on a big chunk of clay. Bam. Nothing but quality music here. Now that's open, the absolute most important thing to do on wide bottom pots is compress the bottom. I always use wooden tools for this.
People are talking about Mix 95.1.
Great job.
And there's a lot to say.
What better way to start the day?
I put it on and keep it on all day while I work.
Humboldt's number one at workstation. Mix 95.1.
Do like one pull, and then the hardest part with making these fermenting crocks is that water mode up top. I'm going to make that now. Better to make it earlier than later, because you'll run out of clay and you'll never have a big enough moat. I've learned this the hard way. Alright, make a few more pulls. It's okay if you did this to the inside of the moat. You can fix it. Once again, I apologize for the lame music. Alright, once I pretty much make the crock, I'm going to go back again, once I find the right wooden rib, and I'm going to compress the bottom again. You can't compress the bottom enough, basically. Just make sure you're not taking up clay when you do this. I'll go back and forth a few times. If sure you get all the water out of the bottom. Now you might be asking, why is he putting this up top like that? Basically, when you make sauerkraut, pickles, any other kind of ferment, you put all your, you know, your stuff in here, and then you, when you put the lid on, you fill this basin with water, and that creates an airlock, which keeps harmful bacteria and mold from getting in your ferment, but allows gases from your ferment to still escape. Now, once I do that, I make my lip. It's basically a little spout, and it helps so when you have your ferment going, you don't want to pull the lid when there's water in there, because that water is going to burp into your ferment. So what I do is I'll make a spout to make it easier for you to get that water out of the moat if you want to check the ferment. Pretty happy with that crock. Gonna make the lid next. I never use calipers, I always use a ruler. It always seems to just work better. By my measurements, I need to make a 8 3/8 inch lid, just coming right now.
You can listen to us at work from
9 to 5.
You got us all day long. Humboldt's number one at work station, Mix 95.1.
All right, let's make a lid. I'm making that opening all of like 1/4 inch deep, because it's already pretty thin on the bottom. Open that up. Because I never like sponge in water. I'll just kind of get my hands wet again. The less water you use, the better. Now I'll go and compress what will be the inside of the lid, which is the bottom now. Now what I'll do is I'm going to dig my finger, kind of pushing in there to get it a little bit under the clay, and then I'm going to make my pole out. This works good for making plates too. I'll get it way down underneath and then pinch. Already wide enough. It's actually too wide. But I like to make the top kind of flare up anyway. It kind of sits better on the crock. And I need it 8 3/8 inch. So still 8.5. Gotta flare it up just a hair more. Kind of hoping they were gonna. They do play good music on this radio station. I was kind of hoping they were gonna put something on I liked while I was doing this, but you get what you get. Perfect 8 3/8 inches long, wide. Start aligned under there with my needle tool, and I'll just come back with my wire tool. I'll actually cut the bottom here. Let it sit overnight, I'll be able to trim it and put a handle on it. Basically, that's the lid to my crock. You saw the base. You get the idea, huh? These are pretty difficult to make, but you make enough of them, you'll get the hang of it. Keep potting. Rock on.